Hi, my name is Callum McCrae, and I'm the principal investigator of the Apple Heart and Movement Study. We really want to understand how changes in individual participants' fitness and heart health over time are related to different types and intensities of activity, and how the responses to those activities predict disease or resilience disease, as well as anticipate how the body will respond to other external challenges, including falls, injury, or just simple inactivity.
Hi, I'm Angela Spillane.
Hi, my name is Courtney Smith.
I'm James Truslow.
Hi, my name is Gabby.
I am Andreas.
My name is Diana.
Hello, my name is Sunny Kapoor.
Hi, my name is Akul Ball. So outside of work, I really enjoy dancing and choreographing new pieces that are a blend of Western and South Asian influences.
Getting outside as much as possible, whether that be in the form of hiking, biking, or just walking.
I enjoy spending time with my family, my wife, my two kids, and my dog, Teddy, who really is a teddy bear.
I think that one of the most important things about the study is that it's able to characterize fitness and health at a resolution that has previously only been feasible in small numbers of people for short periods of time. And so as a result of having access to these unique types of data that have been annotated by all of the participants with their own activities, we're able to understand a lot more about how different activities contribute to fitness and health, and also importantly understand individual trends and responses to different types of exercise. Probably the most important evidence of engagement is the positive responses that we have received when Angela and other team members have reached out to participants around falls or around other specific questions that we're addressing in the study.
With the data that our participants share as well, we're really excited to gain insights on heart health across different lifestyles and fitness levels.
You get a totally different quality of measurements from wearable devices than you do in a hospital setting. You get more continuous observation, you get observations in a greater variety of contexts. And this can allow you to detect changes in health in ways that you really can't in a hospital.
With over 2 million ECGs, we have a unique opportunity to analyze markers of various health conditions, and we have just scratched the surface of the possibilities of the study.
It's exciting to envision the impact a person's own collected data may have on their clinical care as technology continues to transform.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you for your participation.